रुक जाऊं मैं तो फिर भी ये समय रुक पाएगा क्या। टूट कर बिखर जाऊं मैं तो फिर भी मंजिल मुकाम रहम बख्शेगा क्या। ना, हौसला टूट नहीं सकता अब भी, खुद पर मुझको तरस है क्या। बस आखिरी सांस बची हो तब भी लड़ लूंगा मैं, देख लेना क्या। वेल आई थिंक इट इज ईजियर सेड देन डन। यू नो एवरीवन हैज देयर ओन सेट ऑफ पुश, पर रुकावटें तो सबको आती है, पर कुछ मुश्किलें ऐसी होती है जो आपको अंदर से हिला देती, अंदर से तोड़ देती है। हालांकि कुछ हौसले भी इतने बुलंद होते हैं कि कितनी भी रुकावटें कितनी भी मुश्किलें क्यों ना आए, ये टूटते नहीं। एंड नॉट इवन द वर्स्ट ऑफ देयर इंजरीज कैन ब्रेक देम। टुडे वी स्पीक टू वैभवी त्रिवेदी, एन इंटरनेशनल लॉन टेनिस प्लेयर हु हैज रिप्रेजेंटेड इंडिया एट मेनी लेवल्स। नॉट जस्ट दैट, She has won 10 gold, 3 silver, 3 bronze medals in 2 different tournaments.
That's right.
Today, she opens up about a surprise comeback she did after a very severe injury into a National League tournament. Not just that, she just didn't participate, she actually went on to win that tournament. You know, the best part about this particular episode is actually I got to sit in front of someone who was wearing an India jersey which was used at multiple tournaments while representing India. Yes, on this episode of A Night Before, we present to you Vaibhavi Trivedi, raw and unfiltered, unadulterated. Hi, I'm Shrungar Ughani and this is A Night Before, sponsored by Branding Mudra, directed by Jay Nathwani. Vaibhavi, someone who's actually won 10 gold, 3 silver, 3 bronze medal. Girl, you're on fire, right?
Yeah.
I would say, matlab, I've never met anyone who has won so many medals, so many awards, so many recognition in my life. And, you know, I feel so timid right now.
No.
I feel I've not done much in the life, but, you know, to meet you today is a kind of a special thing for me.
Yeah.
Thank you for being here, right? And thank you for being on the episode of A Night Before. You have been playing lawn tennis for almost about 15 years, if I'm not wrong, right? And how did lawn tennis happen to you? When did you think that, you know, you want to play lawn tennis? Have you always been a sports person since your childhood? Or, you know, suddenly something happened and out of the blue...
No, it's like I was a sports person. Like, I was an athlete first, then a tennis player later on. So being an athlete first is my father was a very good sports person.
Oh, nice.
So and my mom, like she used to carry me to race course and Bal Bhavan.
Okay.
And there I used to have, you know, all kind of equipments available for the sports. So I started with athletics very first. Like I used to run, I used to sprint, you know, to prepare my body. I was not preparing my body, but my parents was preparing my body to be a sports person, right?
Okay.
And then I started with swimming first.
Mm-hmm.
I was there in the district team and got selected for the states.
Okay.
And at the same time, like during that time only, like we visited one of the tennis court in Rajkot, and my father just casually asked, you know, you want to try this game?
Hmm.
And I was like, yeah, sure, why not?
Why not?
Yes.
Why not?
Yeah, I'll try that. because I was not included in any ball activity, like racket and ball. I was doing like sprints, running, athletics, long jump, high jump, everything, swimming. But I was not introduced to racket and ball. So I was very, you know, fascinating that, yes, you hit the ball and the sound it produced, you know. So that was, you know, I wanted to try just that. This, yes, definitely I want to try this.
This is something that, you know, there's a lot of energy that goes into this. Almost every athletic thing that energy goes. But then here, it's not just you that you have to play with. You have to take care of another instrument.
Yes,
there's
exactly.
An equipment.
So that was more exciting, you know, that it's not just the body, but you have something more to take care about. And I just, the tennis affair, it started very casually. Just give it a try. It was like that. But like within 1 month, like after 1 month, there was a tournament, district tournament in under 12.
Okay.
I participated and I won the tournament.
Oh.
So I was like, oh, nice. I'm good at racket and ball also, not just swimming.
That is a great thing to win within a month.
Yeah, that was great.
Okay. So then from there, under 12, how did the journey happen till now you are actually representing India at a lot of places,
yes.
Right? You're wearing an Indian jersey, I would say. Something that I would be very, like, very fascinated with, right?
Yeah.
But so how did this journey from playing at under 12 to now playing for India to represent India at a lot of places, right? How did this journey?
It's a long journey.
Obviously, it's been 15 years.
15 years, obviously. For the state tournament in tennis, it was there in Ahmedabad for under 12 state.
Okay.
And swimming also clashed with the same dates, but it was in Bhuj.
Okay.
So for convenience of traveling and everything, my parents decided, let's give a chance to tennis first. So I went for the state tournament in Ahmedabad and I won that tournament in under 12. So I was under 12 state champion at that time. And at that time, like, that was the moment, like, before going to the tournament, that was a particular moment that I have to choose between the two games, like, from what I want to give priority, where I want to focus my energy, where I want to focus, you know, every single energy and my focus and, you know, to sacrifice studies and everything, but to what extent?
Okay.
So there was a time that the main selection was to be done. Yes, so we chose tennis at that time, and after that, throughout, tennis was there. I continued swimming, but it was just for the, you know, fitness purpose, not professionally.
Okay, yeah. And you said your father was also a sports person, so was he also into tennis or,
He played almost every single game, but not tennis.
Every single game, but not tennis. Okay.
He was excellent, like, he was a fast bowler.
Okay.
Excellent fast bowler, he was a Kho-Kho player. For the consecutive 3 years, he made his team Kho-Kho champion for the universities.
Okay.
I think state universities.
Okay. So.
And he was a long distance runner also. High jump, long jump, every single thing he used to do.
Okay. So probably this came to you into the blood, right?
Yes, definitely.
Your father was already into
sport. Yeah, but he was, he and like my mom, she was already interested in tennis even before my birth. Like, my father, he was, oh God, he was literally like, he will put an alarm for 2 o'clock or he'll just wake up at 3 o'clock just to see the Australian Open and everything, even before my birth.
Okay.
So he was that into tennis, but he himself didn't just try that game. But he was very much, you know, I would say I am not that interested in tennis like he is.
Okay, yeah. He's more, more involved into tennis than...
Very passionate.
Okay. Then I think will be something a case where, you know, उन्होंने एक सपना देखा था वो आप पूरा कर रहे हो ऐसा टाइप का. But that is nice. So then you were at that time training into Rajkot, right?
Yes. When
you
initially started in Rajkot. I played here in Rajkot for few months, and then the leading coach of the very good academy from Gujarat, from Ahmedabad, he happens to be visiting Rajkot.
Okay.
He just saw me play, and he saw something in me, and he called just my father, you know, that just give me this girl, like I'll do everything for her, just don't worry. Because again, to put me in Ahmedabad, the finance was the biggest thing. So he said, like, we'll sponsor her. You don't need to worry about anything like food, hostel expenditure, tennis training, fitness. Every single thing will be taken care of. Just give me this girl.
And as we were speaking, speaking earlier, tennis is not that, it is a very expensive sport.
Yeah,
right.
Very.
Not just the rackets, but the nets you have to take care of. Then, for the fitness, you have to do a lot of activities, right? So there are a lot of expenditures that comes with the tennis. So
I still remember, I just started tennis, after 1 month, when I was just 12 year old. After 1 month, my father traveled to Mumbai specifically just to get my rackets. And I was waiting very eagerly, or you can say very excited about it. Yes, I'll get my rackets, my own racket and everything.
Mm.
Then when I shifted to Ahmedabad, after 1 year, on the basis of my performance and everything, I was in under 14, top 13 national rankings. And even before that, my coach recommended me to Babolat. It's a leading, Rafa Nadal and everything, top players plays with Babolat racket. And they sponsored me.
Oh.
So that was, quite good support, to be taken care of equipment, kits, balls and everything, even the shoes part. Stringings, those were the very great support that I can, ask for.
Yeah, obviously, because see, you have a mindset that you'll play.
Yeah.
Right. You can probably be practicing, but then there's a lot of back support that is needed.
Exactly.
Right. If you don't mind me asking, who was the coach who actually took you out of Rajkot?
Yeah, sure. Mr. Pramesh Modi.
Okay, so we should be really thankful to him.
Yeah, absolutely grateful. Me and all of my family, absolutely grateful to him.
Are you still in touch?
Yes, absolutely. We are still in touch.
And do you still train under him?
No, right now I don't train under him, but yes, we are still in touch.
Okay. So he took you to Ahmedabad.
Yes.
And then what was the continuing of the journey? What did you play? For whom did you play? How did you reach up to states, nationals? How long was the journey?
Immediately started. I started playing ITA tournaments after I shifted to Ahmedabad. Mm. ITA is All India Tennis Association.
Okay.
So we have a specific national circuit. We have ranking tournaments that on the basis of our performance, we get ranking points.
Okay.
So yes, we have ranking in place now. And there is school games and national sports competitions that are team events.
Okay.
So you have to give your entry from your school. So initially, at the very basic level, you are representing your school.
Okay.
Then you get a part of a district team. Then you play states. You represent your district. And then you are selected in a state team, top districts. There are, again, a bunch of players, 16 to 8 players. They are separated from the bunch and they play league matches and everything.
Okay.
And from that, top 4 players are selected to represent the state in the national tournaments.
Okay. So it's a rigorous journey to reach there.
So I was a part of that tournament with two of my senior players. One of them is Ankita Raina. She's current India number one.
Okay.
And one of them was Nova Patel. She was then under 14 India number one.
Okay.
So I was, it was nice to be a part of that team. And
to learn from them playing alongside you, right?
Yes.
On a daily basis, practicing along with you to probably, you get to know a lot of things.
Yes, it was a great learning experience playing with them. Being in the same team, that's really an outstanding experience.
Obviously.
So we participated in national school games. It was under 14, held in Ahmedabad only. And we won the gold medal over there. So that was my first national gold medal.
First national gold.
Yes.
Right. And that was in a couple of months.
It was in 2006.
Yeah. So you shifted in 2005.
Yeah, it was just in 2006.
Nice. Did it ever happen to you, things are happening too soon, or
Too soon. I was too young at that time, so don't know about too soon. But yes, I was enjoying the journey. Everything is coming,
And the praises along with that, you might be enjoying that. Okay.
So after that, the award ceremonies and everything. That is the whole different level of experience. You get recognition whenever I just if I travel for some another academy, people start recognizing me. Oh, she's that girl. So that's nice.
But that is true. See, because a lot of time that really boosts our morale, right? You get recognized. A lot of people are probably taking your interviews, right? I think you received awards from a lot of political leaders.
Yes.
Even from the
like
then...
sports awards. That is from Sports Authority of Gujarat.
Hmm.
Sardar Patel Senior Award and Sardar Patel Junior Award.
Okay.
So they see consecutive 3 years of performance for you and then they award you.
Okay.
So I received the award from our Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
The then...
then CM of then Gujarat.
CM. Okay.
Then CM. Also... Anandiben Patel,
okay.
Fakirbhai Vaghela, Rajendra Trivedi and all.
A lot of political...
And in last year, like for 26 January, the celebrations of Republic Day, state level celebrations was in Rajkot only.
Yes.
So at that time, I got an award for, or you can say a recognition for my achievements in tennis from Vijaybhai Rupani and our governor also.
Okay.
So that was quite good. In the same event, Cheteshwar Pujara also got the same recognition for his contribution in cricket.
Perfectly fine.
So
perfectly.
That was good.
Nice. So now when you were anyway playing for national tournament, that was your team tournament, right? When did you start playing individual, when did you start registering yourself as an individual into national tournaments or maybe international tournament?
It was alongside that only.
Mm-hmm.
Like we, the team event, that's once in a year type of thing. Mm. But individual is throughout the year. It's like ITA have a tournament somewhere in the country of different categories every single week.
Okay.
So you got to select your own tournaments which you want to play according your goals and what you want to achieve from the tournament.
Mm-hmm.
So that really depends on that.
So the more tournament you play, I think your ranking, your seeding or what you call,
yes,
gets higher.
It's also about more tournaments and about your performance. Even if you play a little less tournament but your performance is absolutely good, or you can say great, then also you get earn ranking points.
Okay. And so, when did you play for the first time, representing India?
Representing India, like, it was in 2012, ITF events. Like, I started playing ITF events in 2012. So, it's International Tennis Federation.
Okay. So, almost took you 7 years.
Yes, to
of
go
practice
international. Yes.
And, working and everything, that to go to international field, international soils and play.
Yes, I could have done a little earlier, but that was not my goal actually. Like ITF also have junior and senior tournaments. Like under 18, they have junior tournaments. Above 18, that is open circuit. So I, when I was under 16, I had the opportunity to play junior ITF tournaments, but... I had a different goal. Like it was for me, it was not that important at that time to devote my energy and finances in junior tournaments. So we decided to train instead of participating in junior international tournaments. We decided to train as much as possible to improve our game and play directly international circuit in the open women's category.
Well,
so that was the goal at that time.
That
so,
is a great understanding, rather than, rushing to actually play something
on
a bigger level and then actually figuring out that, actually you were not ready for that.
Yes.
Right. And to figure that out in an early stage and then actually, working yourself a little harder and then directly going for the big fish.
Yes.
Right. That is actually a very understanding move, because a lot of people, when it comes that, you're getting a chance to play on an international level, right?
Yeah.
You'd never want to let it go, even
if
it is
exactly.
The smallest chance and you have the highest possibilities that you could not, win or you could not perform well, but you'll still feel that you have represented India or you have represented, yourself on an international platform. So you'd want to do that. You want to grab that chance as early as possible. But that is something really amazing, surprising from your side that, you did not go for that. You actually waited.
Yeah, because like ITF events are again the individual events.
Okay.
You are representing, of course, your country, but it's on the individual platform.
Okay.
So you have to, carry your own finances and everything.
Okay.
So after I finished my under 16, I decided to play national circuit for open category.
Okay.
So, and gradually, like after 2 to 3 years, then I started playing ITF ones.
Okay. So, there'll be a lot of finances in a way that, you the more you win, the you get rewarded in cash as well?
Yes, cash. I was a part of Shaktidut Yojana. That's the initiative by state government, Gujarat government, and Sports Authority of Gujarat. So they do recognize that sports are expensive, and as you go up, your expenses go up. It just shoots up. So the receiving a support from there from them was quite satisfactory that yes, we have someone backing up. So
you don't have to worry a lot about the finances.
Yes, not a lot, and it was good.
Okay, so you started from 2012, right? And when did you win your first international gold?
I don't have international gold.
Not yet. No worry. Cool. We'll have it soon. So probably when the next season we come up with you with, and when you have here again on the episode, we'll have an international.
Fingers crossed for
fingers
that.
Fingers crossed for that. No, no. We'll pray for you. Let us know when your match is, and we'll make sure that everyone in our everyone who's actually following A Night Before or seeing this, we'll make them wish for you. We'll make them pray for you that you win an international gold.
That support is everyone. Every sports person just crave for that, to receive the support.
No, it's always, I've always wanted to, be representing India somewhere, right? I always wanted to do that. It never happened till now. I hope that someday it happens. But, whenever I see someone who's actually representing India anywhere, right, and if I get to meet that person, right, I feel really like, I feel like I am doing that thing.
Yeah.
Right. And that is why I always feel that, whatever that I can do, I'll be able to, I'll just give it to them as much as I can do. Right. It just, I can't think about anything else.
It feels so nice to hear this,
Okay. It was not to make you feel nice, but
no, it's really nice. And I had not won that international gold, but yes, during 2015 or 16, I was there. Yeah, I'm playing international tournaments, and I have not represented India particularly in a team event. I had that regret.
Okay.
But through God's blessing and everything, I got a chance to represent India in World University Games.
Okay.
So that was that is finished. Now I don't hold any regrets now from my tennis career. So I
you have already represented India in two team game.
India in a team atmosphere, that's completely different. So that's really great.
So World University Games, that happened in 2017.
Yeah.
And you that are usually for the students, studying into different universities or colleges.
Yes.
Okay. Cool. So where did it happen?
I was a part of Gujarat University. I was leading Gujarat University team as a playing captain, and we took a silver medal in the West Zone, and we went for the All India.
Okay.
And top 8 finishing teams were called on for the selection trials.
Okay.
And I got selected in the team. That after that it becomes Indian University team.
Okay.
You call India. It's not about Gujarat University anymore. So we were 4 girls selected for India to be represented India, and the tournament in World University Games, it was held in Chinese Taipei.
Okay.
In 2017, and if you go for the importance purpose, World University comes after Olympics. Olympics is the biggest event, and after that, it comes World University. That whole of the world is involved over there.
Okay, so. How long did you play into that? So did you went for quarters? Did you went for semi?
We actually lost, I think, in pre-quarters.
Pre-quarters.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. No
but
worries.
It was a nice experience.
It was a nice experience.
Nice experience and so much to learn. So much to learn.
Well, that I agree. A lot of time when you actually don't win, they are the best teachers, right? You already get to learn a lot that, what kind of mistakes probably you did or what kind of mistakes, as a team you guys did, right? Different kind of experiences that, how other people are better than you or what can be done to, be better, right? So
That gives, a different kind of motivation that for next time you don't want this to happen.
Exactly. And you have that, what do you call you have that hunger, know, when you've lost one, you have that hunger that, you don't want to lose it again.
Yeah, that actually pinches you inside, and that actually motivates you every single day. You just go out there, work out, that's it.
Because you have that match in your mind that, that was the time that you actually could have won but did not.
Yes.
Right. And that, till the time it comes back again, you have that regret that, you know, one day probably I'll go and I'll play those people again and I'll make sure that, you know, India yes. wins and, you know, I am the one who makes India win.
Yes,
right?
that is actually exactly what almost every player thinks.
Every player might be going through, right? Because at that point of time, you don't want to play for yourself. You have that thing in your mind that, you know, we are playing for India. There are about billions of people who are actually, you know, watching you from their home screen or TV screens, you know, that, you know, probably please win for India, you know, make India proud, make India win, right?
And it's amazing to have, you know, India on your back. So that's really great.
You know, that pushes you a lot.
Yes, that pushes, surely pushes.
Okay. When we're talking about tennis and a lot of tournaments, right, what we're talking today about a night before, right, obviously it is not a game of a day or a night, you know, of one particular day or a night. There's a long way that goes behind this, right? But we were speaking that, you know, you went through a long injury, right?
Yes.
Right. And I think it was a knee injury in 2014.
Yes. Like, I had my ankle twisted badly. That was in 2014. Knee was in 2018. Like,
okay.
17, 18.
Okay. So after that knee injury, about 2017, 18, how long you had to rest after that injury?
Quite long.
How long?
It was like 3 to 4 months of rest, and after that I started, you know, rehab and everything. So getting back to the high intensity and competitive tennis, it took me almost a year.
A year?
A year, yes.
Okay.
It happened after World University.
Okay. So you went on to play for World University and then you came back. So after World University, you had an injury?
Yes.
Okay. And then almost took a break of a year?
Yes, almost a year, and then...
From the competitive tennis, right?
Yes.
But you must be practicing...
Yes, practicing. Cool. It was... The rehab procedure is, you know... on and off court, everything, more off court work, a little on court work. You play for half an hour, you play for 45 minutes. You get to know how your body is responding and everything.
Huh.
Then you again, you know, try to manipulate your intensity.
Okay.
Try to manipulate your volumes at what suits your body at that particular time.
Hmm.
So a little more specific that you go, but to get back 100% to the competitive tennis, it took almost a year.
Okay. And what was the tournament that you participated in, you know, after a year?
It was ITA National Ranking Tournament in Gurgaon.
Okay. That was in 2018.
18, yes.
Okay.
18.
Do you remember the month?
It was September.
Okay. September 2018.
Yes.
Right. You're getting back from your injury.
Yes.
Right. It's about the first match that you are playing. Right. Qualifiers.
Yeah.
Right. You were there as a qualifier.
I was there as a qualifier.
Right. You went on to win the qualifier round.
Yes.
Right. Then you went on to win the quarters.
Yes.
Then you went on.
You know, specifically, I remember this tournament. As you said, like, I entered the tournament as a qualifier. I qualified and getting into a main draw. I was playing 8th set in the first round.
Hmm.
It was really a night before that, what you are thinking. It was really, you know, quite nervous.
You had actually nights before every single match
every
of
single
this particular
day, every
tournament,
single day,
right?
Every
so
single day.
So let's start from the first match, the qualifier, right? You were playing against?
Qualifier, like, I was quite confident.
Okay,
you know,
cool.
I didn't know the opponent, but yes, I had seen her practicing. So I was quite confident about that match.
Okay, and then came the quarters. You were playing against 8th seed.
First round, I was playing against the 8th seed. It was round of 32.
Okay.
We had a draw of 32.
So, a night before that.
Yeah. So, after, I was happy to be getting back to competition and again, you know, playing the tournaments. That feeling is really great. Finally, I am over here. So, first thing is, you know, enjoy the moment and all. And then comes this part that, yes, I have a match tomorrow.
I like the tone of notes. I have a match tomorrow.
It's always there on the back of your mind. No matter what you are doing, you already have that, you know, I have a match tomorrow. I have a match tomorrow. Yes. Mm. So you try, first of all, you try to gather as much as information about your opponent. You try to, you know, Google them. If you can find anything about them, their playing style, what they play. You talk about your talk with your friends that how this particular player plays, like do they know anything about it?
Are they aggressive? Are they defensive? Yes, exactly. What are their styles? What are their weaknesses?
What I try to do is I enter the match. I don't want so many surprises.
Hmm.
I try to research about a player as much as possible before the match.
Okay.
So there are a little less surprises during the match.
Okay.
So, yes, it was nice. A little sleepless night, you can say, but it was quite good.
Okay. Well, what were you going through? What did you do that night?
That the research night, only? Like, no, I completed my research and I had my fitness session, everything. Even if you are playing a tournament, you obviously want to keep improving.
Hmm. You don't want to feel next day fatigue or anything.
You just don't want to be lazy over there. So you keep working. I had a... telephonic conversation back home at with my family that this is the player. Yeah, it gives you support. Like tennis being an individual sport, it's a lonely sport. Like you don't have anyone over there
initially
your career. As you progress in your career, you have the privilege of having a traveling coach and everything. But initially you are there alone, figuring out every single thing that you should be doing.
Hmm.
So yes. Match preparation, you prepare your rackets and everything.
Hmm.
I have a habit to, change my grips and everything before a match, before a tournament and everything. So a night before is, preparing the equipments and everything, preparing your kit, that everything is there, whatever I'll be requiring, some extras also. I don't want to be, I don't have this. So preparing the kit and everything, researching about the opponent and... almost you start visualizing your match. So even before you go out there on court to actually physically play the match, it is already started in your mind. Like I'll be serving like this. You prepare your own strategies and tactics that what I'll be doing. And you try to visualize that as perfectly as possible.
Like because if I'll win the toss, this is what I'll do.
Yes, exactly. You figure out every single thing that is under your control.
You figure out positive turnouts, you figure out negative turnouts.
Yes.
Then you think what can be done to, reduce the number of negative turnouts or what you will do if something turns out negative. How will you, try to
so
make
you,
things
you try
more positive.
To, imagine every single possible scenarios in your mind and you put yourself up there that
Agreed.
What I'll be doing in such case, cases. So you basically it's like preparing your mind for the match. Then just have a good night's sleep and again.
So do you tell yourself before a match that maybe now you need to sleep? Please focus on your sleep. Your rest is really important to you. You have to talk yourself out of research and a lot of thoughts because quite a lot of them this happens to me. Right, when I have a shoot or something of this sort. When I have very important days, this happens to me that, though I know that I have to sleep a little early, like about 12 or something, right? I'll not be able to sleep. I'll have to watch a movie or I'll have to watch something on YouTube, prep myself up, again, like the way you say, do my research, right? But then I'll have to tell myself, Shrungar, come on, you need to sleep, you need to... look decent the next day. You don't, like, if you'll be tired, the whole of the shoot, the whole of the thing will get spoiled out. Right?
Yeah.
Do you have to do that?
When I was quite younger, like, one of my father's friend, he was into meditation.
Okay.
So he has, taught me a routine just before you go to sleep that you follow. It's a sound therapy like thing, but yes, I enjoy it and it helps me, to sleep and to, vanish all my thoughts. So that's really good.
So you listen to that and...
Yes, if I struggle too much with the thoughts and everything, I do listen to that.
Okay.
So it's, it's nice to be calm and just go off to sleep.
Okay, so you went into sleep, then you went and played quarterfinals. Right, and you won that.
Yeah.
Right.
Quarters was against the first seed.
Against the first seed?
Yes. Okay. Quarters was against the first seed. And a night before that was also quite a more nervous thing that you can say. That yes, playing a first seed, and she was India number 24 at that time.
Okay.
So yes, having your first top 25 win after you are coming back from an injury.
Hmm.
So that's what every player looks forward to. At least what I entered that match was not exactly to win, but just to give everything that I have, just to give
put up a
great fight. That's it.
Give a great show, just to you know, let people know that you know you can compete.
Yes, there's still something there in me. You know, I'm not over yet.
Yes, the injury has not put your career on a back foot. You are still there as a lioness fighting for your place. Right.
Exactly. So that was always there. You know, you don't for the higher matches or when you play a higher ranked player, you don't always think about winning, but you do always think about to put up a great fight. You know, to give out everything that you have out there on court. That's it. Hmm. You should not be having any regrets. Oh, I didn't do this. Oh, I didn't do this.
We don't want that.
You do every single thing that is possible for you to play your best on court. That's it. On a particular day.
And I think it also happens in a way that, you know, you want to even earn respect in your opponent's eye.
Right? Yes.
You know that that person is already on a better platform or a better stage than what you are at. Right. Not to just for the audience that is around you or the coaches or different other players who are actually watching you play, but also in front of an opponent that you know, if they're better than you, like at a better ranking than you, you want to earn that respect in that particular person's eye that, you know, you gave a fight and they have to come down and appreciate the way you have fought, you know, even if you lose, right? That didn't happen to you, but then you did not just put up a good fight, you actually won that particular thing.
That match.
Right.
Yeah.
And so, did ego strike ever?
No.
No?
No. It's not about ego. It's just let your racket do the
just
talking.
Just a little, that pinch of a pride that, you know, I have defeated a first seed. Did that ever happen? Like, now I can, like...
See, if it's going to happen, then I'll be playing, you know, that not that good in the very next match.
Huh.
If that goes into your mind. Every single day, it's a new day. Like, no matter what rank you are playing, basically what I think is no matter what rank you are playing, you just are playing a ball.
Hmm.
So every time a ball is different. No matter if a 10-year-old hits that ball or some international player hits that ball, you just try to play against a ball, not a particular opponent or a seeding or a ranking or a points.
Okay, that's a very nice perspective.
That's
a very nice perspective that you're not playing a person, you're playing the ball.
Actually, that is how it is. Yeah, it helps, you know, to ease off the pressure. Yeah. You're not playing, you know, this player.
It doesn't make you fly out of the pride or doesn't even make you too much nervous that you are too much grounded.
Yeah.
Right. So that really helps. That is a real nice perspective that you have. Right. So after quarters, you went on to play semifinals.
Yes.
Right.
Semifinals. It was against the fourth seed.
Fourth seed.
Yeah.
Right. And... was the night before that also very, like, you know, drenching or you were nervous?
It was not, as you said, you know, you have a little confidence when you beat top seeds, right?
Hmm.
So I was quite confident that, yes, I put up a great show today and I ended up on the winning side. That's really great. Like, I thank for that. So it gives you confidence. It also gives you self-belief. That yes, you are over here to give your best, and yes, you are actually able to give that on court. So it's like that. Let's see what next day brings, you know.
Okay. So upsetting the eighth seed, the first seed, and then you went on to play fourth seed, and then you even won that.
Yes.
Yeah, you won that. Okay. Then you went on to play the finals.
Yeah, finals.
Okay.
It was against an unseeded player, but that was quite nervousing because you have that thought, oh, this is the finals, you know?
And it is the first tournament that you're playing after a long break because of your injury.
Yes.
Right. You have already created a lot of upsets. So now the eyes are on you. And as you said, the player was unseeded, right?
Yes.
So in a way, she is also an underdog.
Yeah.
Right. You are an underdog.
Yeah, both are underdog. But I was, you know, getting to the finals, upsetting some quite good seeds. So that the players over there or the organizers over there or, you know, someone supporting you. So as you said, like, people have more expectations from you.
Exactly.
So that gives a little extra pressure.
And now you are the senior person there, right? Yeah. In the final, right? That person has the ability to, you know, what do you call, upset, create an upset.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Rather than what you have. Right.
So it was throughout the match, throughout the tournament, I was, on an underdog situation. And for the finals, it was like, oh, now the situation is reversed. Now I have a little more extra pressure, you know, to handle.
Now you don't want to be the person that you've already defeated.
Yes.
Right.
Exactly. And moreover, like, you did everything that you have to do, everything good, great, whatever it is, but you end up winning. You are through to finals and you want to perform best on this particular stage. Because as again, like, people often, you know, less remembers those who stood second. People remember the first ones.
Exactly.
So you always try to be that one.
So because it is about that, you know, they remember the winners, they don't remember the runners up.
Yes.
You know, obviously those people probably who are third, fourth, there are high chances that people remember them because, you know, but second ones, they don't have that of respect usually. Right. So, but how was the night before that? Like, in a way, did you research about that particular player?
Yes, I also did research work, but a little less research was required because throughout the tournament, I was seeing her, that how she plays, whatever. You always have a constant eye, you know, prospective opponents, that she can be my opponent, she can be my opponent, like that.
Okay.
So you keep a watch on them, like, you try to see them matches, how what they do, how they do, and everything.
She was creating upsets. You were creating upsets.
Yes.
How was the final match? Like, was it like a lengthy one, or, you know, very tough, very cutthroat? What?
I expected it to be a lengthy one, but somehow it got finished, you know, with moderate.
How long
energy.
Was it? 2 hours?
1.5 hour.
1.5 hours. Yes. Okay, that's decent.
I expected it to be a little longer.
Usually, you know, such competitions end up having 2.5 hours, 3 hours of long match. So,
yes, yes.
Right. Usually, the finals go on to be stretched for a longer time.
But it's 1.5 hours. That's the normal duration for tennis matches. Hmm. So it was a normal match, but it was a great match.
And you won.
Yes.
So, Vaibhavi Trivedi, from having an injury, having a year break, right, and playing the first tournament, creating a lot of upsets, and then going to win, you know, national circuit, you were there.
Yes.
You won the gold medal.
Yeah.
Right. How was the night after that win?
Night after, it was...
How did you party? How did you celebrate?
That's what I'm telling you. Tennis, it's a lonely sport most of the time. So you don't get to party the very same day, you know. You need to get back over here in Gujarat and then you party.
So you meet your friends. Yeah. So, but how did you celebrate?
We went out for a dinner. That's it.
But
because, as I said, like, we have tournaments throughout the year.
Okay.
So after finishing that tournament, I was again supposed to prepare for the next tournaments. I was playing two consecutive tournaments after a break of 2 weeks.
Okay.
So not much of partying at that time. Yeah.
I had to focus again on the fitness part. Right. But nice. So, and that happened in 2018, right?
Yes,
so
18.
2019, you played in a bigger tournaments? Any bigger tournaments?
Yes. Again, national circuit, we have different tournaments on the national circuit. So I played Jaipur ITA National Ranking Tournament.
Okay.
And I was runner-up in singles and doubles both.
Okay. And after that, 2020 happened. Not much of the games happened. Must have felt really bored at home because then you did not get much to, you know, work out except what your inside your home.
Yes, right? Home workouts
basically. Were only there.
But we had good opportunity from the ITF. Like, they conducted short courses And also Olympic Athlete 365, they had specific short courses for the athletes and players.
Okay.
So it was very good learning experience. You try to learn about your diet more, you know, such things. About you try to train your mental aspect. So in a way, a lockdown was productive. Like you are doing home workouts, but you are not there physically out there on court. But yes, you are doing something on your soft skills.
And how much did you miss your court?
So much.
So much.
So much.
Do you remember the time when you had a chance to go back to your court after lockdown? After the lockdown?
Yes, I purely remember it. It was like finally, this is the day today.
Again, a night before that.
Night before that?
When you knew that, you know, tomorrow probably you'll have the chance to go to the court again, feel that air, you know, feel your lungs with that air, you know, probably, I don't know, I would have hugged that court, I would have lied down on that court. But, you know, what were the thoughts going in your mind? Were you like texting your friends that let's meet tomorrow at court?
It was not that, but because everyone is there, some of the other part of the country, and everyone is there in the lockdown. But when I was there in Ahmedabad, and we had our practice session, like we had, you know, times allotted specifically to maintain social distancing and everything. Not much crowded over there. So that was night, a night before, again, you know, preparing your kit and everything, that finally we are going out there. Outdoors, playing again, hitting the ball, that feeling. It was, I was almost a 12-year-old kid when I again went back on court. You know, the moment that excited me, oh, racket and ball, and the way it feels, and the sound of hitting the striking the ball. And I was like so excited to hear it again, to feel it again, you know. So, almost like a child, almost like a child. Back to childhood, you
know. Back to childhood. Yeah. Because that happened with a lot of people, you know. With us, you know, we went back on, you know, to hold a mic and, you know, speak to people, you know, in a live audience, right? With you as a player, with a lot of people who were back in their home and were missing their passion, right? We almost felt like we had a new birth.
Yes, exactly. Right. That's what I said, like back to childhood, like you starting the journey from the very, that excitement, over a period of time, you get a little bored or something like that.
How many times will you do home workouts and everything?
And this was an opportunity. You have that, you know, excitement again in your eyes, in your body, that yes, we are back on court. You take the things for granted. And you know that this is such a privilege to be out there on court and hitting the balls and everything.
So since then, after the lockdown, has any tournament happened?
Yes, it has happened. But I did not participate in that. I'll be participating next in the coming weeks, because I am preparing myself for All India Civil Services Tournament.
Okay, so, All India. So you are also civil servant. Yes. Okay. What department do you work with?
I work with Income Tax Department.
Okay, you work with Income Tax Department. Yes. You play lawn tennis. Quite good. Yeah. Quite good. That's really.
I got selected in Income Tax on the sports quota only.
Okay. So. Oh, nice. So that's really amazing, and you're continuing to play. That is really important, because a lot of players, that happens, you know, when they've got a job, right? Even though on the sports quota, they then probably leave, you know, playing, you know, for the sake of, you know, tournaments. Probably they play for the sake of, you know, just for the fitness.
Yeah, it happens.
It really is amazing that you're actually even playing the tournaments.
Yes, my department is really supportive for that. They are encouraging us to, you know, play on the national circuit, on the international circuit. So it's really, I would say I'm truly grateful to them that not everyone have this opportunity. And it's a different kind of freedom that you earn, you spend, you win. That's a different kind of feeling
because it's now your money that you're putting at the stake, rather than taking money, you know, as a loan from your parents. Like in India, we don't have the structure of a loan, but then you know, you always feel that, you know, if you are spending on yourself, then you'll be like more, you know, more excited about every single penny than you earn. So as a father,
2018, the tournament that we talked about, it is really special to my heart because of this reason also. Like, this was the first tournament after I joined my job.
Okay. And so, then you went on
to winning the tournament.
To win the tournament, yeah. And make your department also proud that, yes, you know, you've done this.
Yeah.
I was about to ask, is your father still that excited about you, about every tournament? Because I think he's more of interested in sports as per se. And even then, now since you are a, you know, full-time sports person,
yeah,
right? Does he still get excited on every single match?
Every time. I am still a little girl for him. Like, okay. What we have a ritual type of thing is, after the match, I'll just call him, Papa, hun jeeti gayi. It's the same dialogue that I use, like, when I was 12 year old, or even if right now also, after the match, I'll just call him, whatever it is, like, and he just, you know, says, oh, you are my little girl still today. Like, it's a moment of, you know, a little emotional bonding. And true, we cherish that.
Yeah,
and now I'm grown up right now. So when I say Papa ho jeeti gayi, he'll say, ha, Papa ho jeeti gayi, mane khabar hai jati. So
no,
it's
but then
really
you've
good.
Come a long, long, long way.
Yeah.
Right. It must have not been an easy journey. Right?
Absolutely not.
Right. A lot of this was one of the injuries we spoke about.
Yeah.
You've had other injuries as well. You've even come back from them.
Yeah.
Right. You've won two tournaments after those as well, but. There's still a long way that I feel that, you know, you'll be going, you know, probably,
yeah,
someday we'll see you playing an Olympic too, if that happens, right?
Fingers crossed for
Fingers
that.
Fingers crossed for,
yes,
that, right? We'll hope, we'll pray,
yeah,
right? And, you know, we'll be really happy, you know, if someday when that happens,
yeah,
we'll shoot a night before your Olympic game or, you know, with that, you know.
This already gives me goosebumps, you know.
No, we really are hoping that, you know, nature brings that to you,
yeah,
right?
Sure.
And then when on that particular day, we'll try that, you know, we capture those raw moments with you. And
sure,
let's hope that happens as soon as possible.
Yes,
right? All the
absolutely.
Best to you.
Thank
and
you.
It was really, really, really nice. I feel really good that, you know, I had you on this podcast episode. And
thank you.
I would be really sure that all those people who are actually watching this episode,
yeah,
or hearing to this episode in an audio platform, they'll be really happy, you know, to know about someone who's done so much into the field of lawn tennis and who's a star already, but then is going to shine a little brighter in near future.
Yes, hope,
right?
So. And obliged and grateful for this opportunity.
Arre,
thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I am Shrungaru Kahani, and you have been listening to A Night Before, a podcast created of unadulterated conversations, sponsored by Branding Mudra and directed by Jai Nathwani. Intro music to this podcast has been created by Harsh Sunil Trivedi. Background music has been given by Mohit Kamoti. Logo for the podcast has been created by Monik Patel. Yogesh Solanki has been the camera assistant. Our production team included of Jeet Rugani, Hussein Popatia, and Himang Burija. Through this podcast, we even tried to lessen our usage of plastic water bottles, thanks to our friends at Waterbox. We know all of you are busy creating your own stories, and we sincerely hope that one day you become our guest on A Night Before.